Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make cheese roll. Now cheese roll is a delicious Guyanese pastry that's stuffed with, you guessed it, cheese. So let's get right to the recipe. The first thing I'm going to work on is my pastry dough. I'm going to add 2 cups of flour, 1.5 cups of shortening, and 1.5 cups of butter to a medium-sized bowl before using my fingertips to mix the dough together until it is crumbly like it looks here. Another tip my nanny taught me is to use the palm of your hands to rub the dough together, and this will also lead to the same crumbly texture as if you were to use your fingertips. At this point, I'm going to gradually add some ice-cold water to my crumbly mixture. I'm going to continue to mix the crumble with my fingertips, but this time I'm bringing the crumble together, as you can see here. You want to make sure that that texture of your dough is soft, and if it's not, you can always gradually add a little bit more water. I'm then going to form my dough into a long log shape, wrap it in saran wrap, and put it in the fridge for 1 hour. This is a really important step to achieving a nice pastry that's easier to handle. While that's in the fridge, we can move on to our cheese mixture. Now, I've grated about 1/2 block of marble cheese, and I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of mustard, 1 teaspoon of hot pepper, 4 teaspoons of mayonnaise, 1¼ teaspoon of parsley, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper, and 1/4 teaspoon of garlic powder. And as always, all of the measurements and the ingredients that I am using for this recipe are in the description box below. I'm going to mix that cheese mixture until it resembles a paste, wrap it in saran wrap, and lay it aside until I'm ready for it again. At this point, it's been 1 hour and I'm ready to work with my pastry dough again. So I'm going to part my dough into 12 pieces and roll them with my hands into smooth, textured balls. Now comes the fun part, which is actually creating your cheese roll. You're going to take one of those balls and roll them out similarly to how I'm doing it here. Once in a vertical direction, and then you're going to flip your dough over in a horizontal direction and roll it again. Next, you're going to line the edge of your pastry with some ice-cold water, and then add the cheese mixture to the middle of the pastry dough and give it a nice spread all around. The reason is because you want to make sure that when you bite into your pastry, there's going to be some cheese in every bite. Now you're going to fold your pastry over into 2 like I'm doing here. I'm then going to cut my edges just so that it's nice and straight, and I'm going to use the back of a fork to press down on those edges and then make a simple design on top of my pastry, also using my fork as well. Let's try that one more time just so you get the hang of it. So once again, you're going to roll your dough vertically, then flip it over and roll it horizontally. You're going to add your water to the edge of your dough, spread your cheese mixture all around, fold it into 2, and cut the edges. Then use the back of a fork to press down the edges and form a simple design on top of your pastry. Think of it almost like a pattern. Roll, water, cheese, fold, design. Roll, water, cheese, fold, design. That helps me sometimes, and hopefully it'll make it a little bit easier for you to remember the steps. Now you're just gonna repeat this until you're all the way finished. All right, so now that we're done actually creating our cheese roll, we're just going to give it a nice glaze. All I've done is crack an egg, whisk it, and add a little bit of yellow food coloring to it to give it this color. Now I'm going to glaze over top of my cheese roll with it. And a note about this is that I periodically check on my pastry in the oven and I add more glaze to it if it needs more color. So definitely don't throw out this mixture right away. Now that that's done, I'm going to pop it in the oven for 40 minutes at 355 degrees. So there you have it, fresh out of the oven, your Guyanese style cheese roll, ready to eat and ready to enjoy. I hope that this video was easy for you to follow and that you tried this recipe at home. If you liked it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave all of your comments below. Thanks for watching and see you next time.